Welcome to part 4 of my video series on prostatitis. This video is about asymptomatic inflammatory prostatitis. Now, why would you care about something you don't feel? Because it always causes uncertainty among patients when it is brought up to the table, and there may be implications regarding benign prostatic enlargement and even prostate cancer. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. And at the end of the video, I am going to suggest solutions what you can do to protect yourselves from prostatic inflammation. If you have watched the other parts of this video series, you will remember that the National Institutes of Health subdivides prostatitis into 4 categories. Asymptomatic inflammatory prostatitis is category 4, and it is a lab diagnosis. In other words, you don't feel it, but it shows up in prostate biopsies and by inflammatory cells in the ejaculate or prostate secretions. The prostate specific antigen, PSA, is elevated, and as you may recall from my PSA video, inflammation of the prostate is something that makes PSA rise. We are not talking cancer yet. Category 4 prostatitis is very interesting because it may hold the key to understanding diseases of the prostate we so far haven't quite figured out. From the large trials that investigated the effect of drugs for symptomatic benign prostatic enlargement, we have learned that chronic inflammation of the prostate is a common finding in these men. In the MTOPS trial, 45% of the men biopsied had category 4 prostatitis. In the reduced trial, it was nearly 78%, and in the prostate cancer prevention trial, it was likewise 78%. This finding suggests a link between chronic inflammation and the development and progression of symptomatic benign prostatic enlargement. So far, we haven't been able to figure out why exactly some men develop large prostates while others don't. So, inflammation could be the missing link. But there is more. In the histological diagnosis of prostate cancer, neighboring areas of chronic inflammation are frequently reported as well. Inflammation is commonly associated with an overall elevated cancer risk, although in prostate cancer, the current scientific evidence is somewhat contradictory. However, infections are associated with prostate cancer, especially sexually transmitted infections. We know from a meta-analysis of 47 studies that a history of any STI resulted in an almost 50% elevated risk for prostate cancer. Especially gonorrhea, mycoplasma, and any subtype of ureaplasma were associated with prostate cancer risk. So, what are risk factors for type 4 prostatitis? Infection could indeed be the trigger, but also urine reflux, diet, estrogens, or a combination of these factors. Age and lifestyle contribute to inflammation as well. As we age, general inflammation of the body will be an ever-increasing companion. What we eat and how we move will contribute to this process. From large observational studies, we know that physical activity, weight loss, and diet have an impact on prostate health. Dietary patterns that lead to elevated insulin levels and promote inflammation are associated with prostate cancer risk and progression. Looking at dietary patterns is better than looking at isolated foods because there is an interaction of the single components of our diet. If you now want to know what it is that determines a pro-inflammatory diet, I can tell you that I was surprised myself when I found this article from 2016 where they developed and validated an empirical dietary inflammatory index on 39 predefined food groups. Okay, meat is bad, that's yesterday's news. But not all vegetables are anti-inflammatory. According to their listing, fresh tomatoes are pro-inflammatory. And guess what's anti-inflammatory? Beer and pizza. Okay, I think I will have to come back to this point later. In October, I will continue my education in nutritional medicine in Eckernförde, and I will definitely bring up this point for discussion. The other thing is hyperinsulinemia, which is interrelated to inflammation. These two biological pathways link diet to cancer risk. including the risk for prostate cancer. Why insulin? Because this hormone is a key player for cell proliferation and programmed cell death. In other words, important mechanisms for cancer development. Excess body weight will aggravate the problem because obesity will go along with hyperinsulinemia and increased inflammation of the body. Losing body weight and vigorous activity have been shown to reduce inflammation and, let's stick to the subject, also the risk for benign prostatic enlargement and lower urinary tract symptoms. I think by now you agree that category 4 prostatitis is the intellectual form of prostate inflammation. Solving this puzzle will lead to a major breakthrough in urology and medicine. So here's what you can do. Stick to a healthy anti-inflammatory diet. Work out regularly and reduce excess body weight. Protect yourself from sexually transmitted infections. Check out my videos on STIs to find out who is at risk. If you haven't watched the other parts of this prostatitis series, here's the link. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.